Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Vivon Education. In previous class we discussed about trigonometry. In the topic we discussed again naming the sides in a right triangle and trigonometric ratios. Those are what sine, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosecant by using hexagon. Okay, so once again we will recall the six trigonometric ratios: sine, cos, tan, cot, secant and cosecant. So how will you remind in easy way? Means sine indicates what? Side opposite to hypotenuse. Cos indicates what? Adjacent to hypotenuse. And tan indicates what? Opposite to adjacent. And cot indicates adjacent to opposite. Sec indicates hypotenuse to adjacent. Cosec indicates hypotenuse to opposite. So you can remember in easy way like this. Now what is today topic? Our topic is today is about complementary angles. So we know what is the meaning of complementary. Yes, we know that two angles are said to be complementary if their sum is equal to 90 degrees. So nothing but the sum of two angles equals to 90 degrees, then we can say those two are complementary. Suppose I'm taking a right triangle here. Suppose here A, B, C is a right angle triangle, right angle at B. Since here already this is 90, what you will say about A and C? Those two angle compulsory, angle A plus angle C should be equals to 90 degrees. Isn't it? Because we know that sum of angles in a triangle is equals to 180. Here 90 and this 90 becomes 180, then it forms a triangle, right? Suppose let I am taking angle A is equals to x degrees, then what you will say about angle C is nothing but 90 degrees minus x. Then these two angles should be complementary. Yes, isn't it? So now we will see what are the formulas of complementary angles. I am using a hexagon again. Nothing but it's a polygon which consisting of six faces joining the vertices writing six trigonometric ratios. Those are what? Sine, cos, tan, cot, secant and cosecant. Okay, so first formula, I'm deriving directly sine to cos. First one, sine to cos, tan to cot, secant to cosecant. Okay, so how will you get sine theta? Means here first formula, first one is about sine theta is equals to cos of 90 degrees minus theta, isn't it? Straight line. Okay, and from coming to tan theta, what you can say about tan? How will you get tan theta? Means cot of 90 minus theta, 90 degrees minus theta. And what is about third one is nothing but how will you get a secant theta? Means using cosecant of 90 degrees minus theta indicates what? The secant theta. Okay, now just I am doing reverse. Yes, I am doing fourth one again. So how will you get cos theta? How will you get cos theta indicates what? Reverse. Cos is equals to sine of 90 minus theta, 90 degrees minus theta. Then what is about this one? Cot. How will you get cot theta? Cot theta is equals to reverse. Tan of 90 minus theta. Isn't it? And the sixth one, reverse. How will you get cosecant theta? Cosecant theta indicates what? Secant of 90 degrees minus theta. So these are the six complementary angles. Okay, sine to cos, cos to sine, tan to cot, cot to tan, secant to cosecant and cosecant to secant. So simple, you can remember in an easy way by using this hexagon. So next topic is about identities. So what is the meaning of identity? So identity is that mathematical equation which is true for all values in the variables of the equation is known as what? Identity. Generally we know, everyone, A plus B whole square is equals to what? A formula: A square plus B square plus टू ए बी इट्स अ आइडेंटिटी. सो फॉर द वॉट एवर यू टेक द वैल्यूज ऑफ इंस्टेड ऑफ ए एंड बी इफ यू टेक एनी कॉन्स्टेंट इट विल शोज द बोथ एल एच एस एंड आर एच एस इज द सेम दैट्स वी विल से इट इज एन आइडेंटिटी. सो लाइक दिस ऑल्सो वी हैविंग अ ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक आइडेंटिटीज. सो दट वन अगेन आई एम गोइंग टू यूज सेम हेक्सागोन एंड विल प्रूव दट वन. ओके विल सी हाउ विल रिमाइंड इन ए ईजी वे. Drawing a hexagon again, then joining the vertices, then middle I am writing as 1, simple, just I am writing 1 middle, so using ratios, sin, cos, tan, cot, secant and cosecant, okay, so I am taking alternative ones, I am taking See, just I'm shading, I'm showing these parts. I'm using these parts, these three parts. We'll write the formulas. Okay? So, first, I'm using clockwise direction. Using clockwise. Clockwise, I'm keeping symbol as a plus. Is it okay? Okay? So, clockwise from here to here like this. And starting from here to ending like this. Starting from here and ending like this. Is it okay? I'm considering in here. Clockwise direction. Now see, I'm writing identity first identity. I'm writing as the first one, starting from sine, cos, and come to one. This is a clockwise direction. First identity I'm writing as sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to one. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to one. This is the first identity. Second one, starting is clockwise from here, right? So first, what is there here? One plus cot square theta. 1 plus cot square theta is equals to what? Cosecant square theta. It's the second identity. And the third identity, what is there here? Starting from clockwise, tan. Nothing but what is there here? Tan square theta plus 1 is equals to what here? Secant square theta. These are the first three trigonometric identities. While using clockwise direction. What will happen if we change this one direction anti-clock? We'll see now. So again I'm taking a hexagon, drawing a hexagon. Joining the vertices. Okay. Just a middle I'm writing as 1 here. 6 ratio sine, cos, tan, cot, secant and cosecant. Okay, again taking same parts here. Now I'm using a anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise means what I'm taking symbol is what on here? Minus. Okay. So, clockwise, it becomes what? Anti-clock, like this. Anti-clock. Again, anti-clock. Is it okay? Now, what's the first formula? Check it here. Anti-clockwise, what is symbol I'm considering here? Minus. So, starting from here, right? Anti-clockwise. So, 1. Anti-clockwise symbol what here? Minus. 1 minus cos square theta. 1 minus cos square theta is equal to what here? Sine square theta. It's the first formula. And the second one starting from here to, it is an anti-clock. What is it here? Cosecant theta. Nothing but cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. Cosec minus cot is equal to 1. Okay, starting and ending, you have to check the direction. So what is it here for starting direction here? Second. Nothing but second square theta. And coming from here, minus 1 is equal to what? Tan square theta. Yes. So, we got the identities from clockwise and anti-clockwise by using what? A hexagon method. Okay. So, it's a very easiest process. So, just I used a hexagon to know the identities of trigonometry. So, today what we had discussed, we discussed about the complementary angles. So, how it means direction. Sine to cos to sine, tan to cot to tan, secant to cosec, cosecant to Second, for what? Complementary angles. Okay. Then what we discussed about the trigonometric identities. So by using clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. Okay. It's a very easiest method. I hope you got it. Thank you so much.